Hey, good morning. Welcome to my kitchen. This is where the real magic happens, right? This is where all my grubbing is going down. Still festive. Santa Claus just hanging out. I got some garland and stuff up here. I got to try to take down maybe this week if I feel like it. But yeah, I got, I just figured I'd mix things up a little bit. So, yeah, this is my kitchen. Maybe we'll do some cooking stuff one day. I kind of show you. But, yeah, I just had my breakfast about 30 minutes ago. I got the non-stimulator in here. I have to take it to go. And I'm going to take this. I got some Pulse, or sorry, some pre-gym coming in. I got to take this with me because we have an appointment at the gym. They're going to do my body fat percentage. Oh, I got new AirPods, too. My other ones. Remember, I was complaining about the music not playing all the time? But I got some new AirPods. But yeah, I'm gonna take my pre-gym to go. I mean, non-stim is in this, and I'm gonna take my stimulated. And then I got some electrolytes in here. My breakfast was four eggs as usual. These are those crunchy granola bars I talk about. There's two in here. They're not very good, to be honest, but they got 30 grams of carbs. They got, you know, some fiber, protein, and they got 7 grams of fat. So I had one of those. I had a banana. Check these out. I went to the store last night to get some bananas. These are like 8-9 inch bananas, but the greenest bananas ever. They didn't have any that were ripe. So I didn't have one today, just to be honest. So to make up for some of the carb loss, I had a cookie, sugar cookie with sprinkles. They were bomb, dude. They're so fresh. There's a bakery across the street. They got some good stuff. But to celebrate the new year last night, I had some sugar plum sparkling, what is it? I don't even know what you call it. Just sparkling drink. Yeah, nothing crazy, man. I went to bed at like 9 p.m., got plenty of rest. But yeah, we're going to keep this thing interesting. I'm going to just do the car talk in the evening. But yeah, maybe we'll migrate around the house. I'll show you the Blackstone. I'll show you Sadie. She's outside playing right now. And then we'll just keep this thing fun, you know, just a little different. I mean, this is my third take already because it's just so awkward in my house. I feel like it's just so comfortable just driving and you know, shooting the crap. But I'll get confident, more confident as this thing goes. Dude, okay, I have to brag. So my other pots and pans were abused. So this is best Christmas gift I got. Nothing like, not top of line stuff, but T-Fall is pretty good. New pots and pans. And then, of course, I got my old cast iron in here. I hear lately I have been frying my steaks on the stove on the cast iron with just butter. The butter on the black, I mean, it works on the Blackstone, but it just makes a mess. And it's kind of cold outside, so I've just been doing it here, and it's still bomb. But, yeah, we're going to go. We got an appointment. They're going to measure my body fat, and they're going to take some measurements of my arms and stuff. It'll be fun, and I'll give you guys a report. I think we're going to start recording the warm-up, too. A little bit more raw and, you know, uncut, if you will. Sorry, this will get better. I don't know why I'm a little anxious just chilling in my kitchen. You'd think it'd be, you know, I live here, I'd be comfortable, but I don't know. It's just new. We'll get better at this. But yeah, I'll see you guys at the gym. All right, I lied. We skipped the warm up. Let me grab some weight real quick. We had an appointment with Gage here. There's another bodybuilder. He's been really kind and helpful. He's working on us with our form and stuff. And he gave me some good feedback. I need to work on my upper chest. So we're gonna mix things up a little bit. We're gonna do some incline dumbbell. Some things I gotta work on is the slow eccentric, fighting the weight as I come down and then really squeezing when I go up. So we're gonna start with some incline dumbbell. A typical flat bench. We're still gonna do some flat bench, but I'm gonna take this guy's word. He's a pretty big cat, and he's been super kind and helpful. So let's get a few sets of these, and then I don't know. We're just gonna ride with him today. See whatever he says. Again, guys, don't be afraid to learn stuff. Don't be too stubborn, man. Especially if you're new like me. Be a sponge. Take it all in. Let's play a crazy song and send me these 70 pound dumbbells I can get. Thank you. I don't even know how many that was. That was good. Woo! Do a few more. I didn't even talk about my body fat. 26%. So 80s felt pretty good, or 70s felt pretty good. I'm gonna try to do 80s this time. And someone just grabbed them. So someone just grabbed them. I'll do 75s. I should have had him ready, guys. That Gage here, he's gonna spot me.
There you go, big squeeze. Come on. Good, let's go. Come on, come on. Two more. Two more. All you. One more, one more. Come on. One more now. One more help.
Impress. How about drop?
There you go.
Thanks, bro. Damn. That's sick. Woo. Alright, let's do one more. Those are insane. I got a chest pump already. Thanks to Gage here. Yeah, just be open, guys. Just be open. I'm just gonna be open this whole lift and listen to his guidance. You know, I don't have to do everything that he says for sure, but you know, he's making some good points so far, and I'm gonna start incorporating them into my workouts. But yeah, anyway, enough talking. Let's get it. They're pumped. My chest is pumped already. Curious to see what we're doing next. Fuck. Curse word, curse word. That was good. Yeah, we're definitely mixing it up today. We're gonna do an ISO press. So this is replacing the flat bench. I did a 45 and a 35 or 25 for a warm-up, and I guess the trainer here thinks I'm strong, so he put two 45s on each side and a band. And yeah, one long band loop around twice. So this is me as I can. So chest up and really eccentric. You know, that's stuff I gotta work on is time under tension, right? I feel like a lot of this stuff I kind of just bang out. So he's really wanting me to focus on feeling the weight as I go down. Don't let it tap back here. And then push, keep your chest up. This is gonna replace the flat bench. And again, I'm loving this so far. Look, I'm drenched. Not that we're gonna do everything based on us today, but this is giving me a lot of good ideas. And again, just be open, man. Just be open. Have fun. All right, let's see. Oh, that's heavy as fuck. Sir. Oh, I'm cursing a lot today. This is intense. That felt good, man. Oh, I'll admit, two exercises. My chest is pumped already. Oh, let's do a few more, whatever he says. All right. Let's get it again. So I know I was telling you guys about the body fat check, so they have a free consultation. And I'm glad. I'm really glad. Learning a lot of stuff. Hope you guys are enjoying the hoop video from yesterday. Ice in my veins. My musical play, man. There you go. Oh man, the squeeze on this is legit.
One more. Press.
Dude, thanks. Woo. Thanks, bro. Oh, man. Gage is kicking my ass.
All right, now we're going to do some pec deck. So he helped my form out a little bit. So you definitely want your chest proud. But one thing I was doing was starting wide and then squeezing like this. So you want to almost, it is a fly movement. This is all stuff I learned right then. You want to treat it like a press at the start, engage your pecs from the start. And when you come up, try to touch your elbows together. So, yeah, there you go. Let's do a few of these. Chest proud. Good. That was a lot, but I like the squeeze. Different form than I'm used to, but hey, we're new to this, right? We're gonna figure it out. We're gonna get better as this thing goes on. So I'm loving this free consultation. This is sick. All right, let's do a few more of these, or until he tells me not to. I wasn't really keen to like someone follow me working out, but I'm beating this dead horse. But you gotta be a sponge, man. Don't be stubborn. You know, it's a little awkward having someone watch me record too. But yeah, I'm thankful. This is giving me a lot of good ideas. This pec machine, I've got an insane pump today, more so than I normally get. Maybe it's because I've been doing the same split for so long and the same exercises. So it's good to, you know, increase some new stimulus. He gave me some feedback. It was fair. It wasn't harsh or anything, but I need to work on my upper pecs. You know, he said I'm really strong in my press movements, but my upper pec needs a lot of work. So he told me to let go of the ego and maybe stop doing so much flat bench for now. But we'll see. We'll still do some. All right, chest proud. Try to touch your elbows. One thing I'm getting better too today is my cadence. Thank you.
It's been a sick day. It's been good. Woo! I am pumped. All right, Gage has left us. He has another client. Yeah, free consultation was awesome. But yeah, let's do something. If we do a couple more of these, and we'll do some cable variations. He actually recommended doing them towards the start of the lift too, which I don't know. I feel like I was drinking from a fire hose today. So the guy actually competes. So, and that's the goal too. We talked about all kinds of stuff, like lifts, you know, nutrition. He's a nutritionist too. We talked about, you know, hormone therapy. We talked about a lot of stuff. It's got my gears going. But yeah, let's do one more of these and we'll do some cable variations to get out of here. Do the pose off. Can't forget the pose off. Pec decks are going in the routine for sure. Holy crap. All right, since we didn't do any dips today, I'm thinking high to low raises or high to low flies. Try to squeeze the lower head of my pec and really get a good contraction. I mean, you'll hit all your middle of your chest, but try to focus on the middle and the lower. Awesome workout so far. I am. My chest is full right now. Feels good. Yo, I didn't even talk about the drip today. So this is an old Orvis t-shirt I've had for like 12 years. Look, the collar is ripped, but I need to mix up my daily outfit. I've been rotating the same like four stringers and three long sleeves and hoodies. So I'll try to mix it up a little bit, give you guys some excitement. But I'm thinking of like two, three more sets of these. Loving the squeeze in this. I've not done high to low in a long time, but do two to three sets of these and we'll get posing, and then I'll see you guys in the car. My song will play. Maybe it's my phone. Something's going on. I thought the other AirPods was messed up. Maybe because I take them on and off too much. Really stretch up, chest proud, squeeze down. Let's do one more. See how it feels. Feel good, man. Feel good. I had like a minute rest. Let's do one more. Go. Posing. This is best chest day I've had in a long time. Long time. I'm gonna make it a point to mix it up like I did today and do more incline. More pec deck too. Yeah, I'm cooked. I'm cooked. See you guys in the studio. All right, chest day's done. I was a little, I knew my body fat percentage was high. I guess I didn't realize it was 25%, but that's okay. Take my mic off. Do the pose down, y'all's favorite part. I don't ever want to rush time, but I can't wait to fast forward a year from now and see what it looks like. But I have to take the shirt off for this. Yeah, 25%. Let's do some. Awesome, awesome workout. I've said that like 16 times today, but I'm happy we mixed things up for sure. I don't know if we're gonna do exactly the same stuff, but definitely focus more on incline and pec deck. But anyway, we'll yap about that in the car or the truck. I'll see you guys in there. Get some of that. Chest day's done. Whoo! There's so much going through my brain right now. I love making content for you guys, but when all that was going on, I definitely know I wasn't entertaining or like really focused on the camera as much, because I was just really, really like soaking all the information in. So this guy is, he's a bodybuilder, like competes and stuff. Like, oh, that's my tripod, my bad. And he was not harsh or anything. Like, he was just honest and just being really helpful. So one thing that he recommended, he likes the split I'm doing. And he likes the sets and stuff. But some things I got to work on is my cadence for sure, which I know I had some comments on that, was my cadence. Almost the thing that stuck with me a lot was feeling the weight. You know, instead of just dropping the weight, feel the weight as you come down. To kind of engage some of those deeper, you know, muscle fibers is what he said. I don't know. But he liked the workouts. But one thing he mentioned was being a natural lifter, because this dude is not natural. I mean, I don't know what kind of cycles he's on. I know he mentioned TRT, which is fine. Totally fine. I've talked about that a lot. I have no issues with any kind of hormone therapy or anything, as long as you're safe with it, right? And not like, you know, being reckless with it. But he said that my volume was too high to be natural. And I know a lot of you guys said the same thing, like only need to work out 3 days and whatnot, but I'm gonna struggle with that because I like making content and I wanna be consistent. So I'm not saying I'm gonna completely, you know, I'm not going to cut my volume in half, but we're going to drop the volume down for sure. Work on more. Dude, the cadence, I feel like I did half of the working sets on chest that I normally do, and my chest has not been pumped like this in the 6 months. But we're going to stay 6 days a week. I'll drop the volume down a little bit. Definitely going to incorporate, I appreciate his feedback, because he was like, he's like, all right, let's get personal. He's like, you know, take your shirt off, let me look at you. And he was like, and I didn't know any of this was happening today. I thought he was just going to measure my body fat. But he was like, all right, you guys want to do nutrition or what? So we talked about nutrition, and you know, then he wanted to follow us around and do a workout. But anyway, he was saying, you know, he's like, you, he's like, you're wide, which is great, you know. He's, you know, that's going to help you longer, you know. He's like pretty much saying, he's like, I got a good V taper from the front. He was like, but from the side, he's like, my back and stuff looks good, but I need to work a lot more on my upper chest. He's like, your chest and your pressing is really strong, but you know, all of my muscle, all of my, most of my pec muscle is, you know, in the middle and in the bottom part, you know. So I'm going to focus, I mean, we've always done incline, but I'm going to really make it a priority to focus my compounds, you know, my, a lot of my exertion on incline. I mean, we're still going to do some flat bench too, because I want to see, like, I definitely want to get three plates, you know, eventually, but I'm just going to do incline dumbbells and see where it goes. Maybe take a step back from the flat bench press, and then after a while, go back and see how much stronger I am, you know? And I've talked about this in other videos, and, you know, you might be hypocritical a little bit, but I think it's important to mix things up. I don't think it's important to mix things up every week, but I think if you're doing the same workout for months, which I'll be honest, mine has been pretty similar, you know, for the past, you know, 2 or 3 months. I'm just going to mix it up. And he kind of laughed. He's like, hey, bro, I get it. He's like, you know, bench press is like the lift. He's like, it's all ego. He's like, everyone wants a big bench press. But he's like, if you're doing this to bodybuild and not powerlift, he's like, you got to let go of your ego. He's like, you got to let it go. And I was like, man, all right, I will. Because I want to get stronger, but I want to look good. You know, I'd rather be aesthetic versus like a big powerlifter. I mean, powerlifters can be aesthetic. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? But yeah, great. I'm actually going to tag on with him next week, or no, this Friday. Is it this Friday or next Friday? Do arm day. Cause he, you know, he was just being honest. He was like, you know, he's like, you got a good chest. He's like, your arms could use a little work. He's like, you got a good push, but to finish out, he's like, your triceps, you know, need to be a lot stronger. So I'm curious to see what he does on arm day or what's different, you know what I mean? And again, I'm not going to do everything this guy tells me, but dude, the proof is in the pudding. My chest is pumped, dude. I'm going to be sore tomorrow. And my volume wasn't near as much. So, I don't know. I always feel like I'm intense. I think it really is the eccentric, you know, the slower cadence really, you know, messed me up. But so just to recap, we did the incline dumbbells. I could have done 70 or I could have done 80s, but they were taken up. They only had one set of 80 pound dumbbells. So I did the 75. I didn't count again, but he counted. I think he said I got at least 9, but just to be modest, let's just count 8. So let's say we did 75 for 8. I want to say the first set was more. The first set was at least 10. I'll go back and watch the footage. But we did some incline dumbbells. We did 2 really heavy sets, and then we dropped the weight down and just went as insane as I could. So we dropped down to 65 and did those. And then we did the isolation, you know, press, which was dope because it actually started wide and it squeezed in the middle. We did 2 45-pound plates on each side with the resistance band. I didn't hate anything about that workout. Maybe we just do that. I mean, the guy's a bodybuilder and he's huge. Like, I don't think he was just blowing smoke. Like, he seemed like a genuinely good dude. And he was jazzed about me wanting to get a body lift, and especially being natty. I mean, he did his, you know, his pitch for hormone, you know, TRT and stuff, but he loved the fact that I was natty and trying to see how long I can go. I don't know. I mean, I'm just being fully transparent. There's going to be a day when I hop on a little TRT.
because I want to compete. And you can't compete without a little help. Sure, you can naturally bodybuild and compete in the natural, you know, sector, but I want to do the classic, you know, just huge, man. That's what I want. That's like my dream. So, I don't know, man. We'll just see how I'm definitely going to go nat, and I'll tell you guys when I don't. I'll absolutely tell you guys when I don't. But the reason why I'm wanting to stay natty, too, is because the gains are still good. You know, I'm still making a lot of progress, and my strength is still going up. You know, maybe as I get, you know, more aesthetic and I feel like my strength is kind of, you know, plateaued, if you will. Maybe then, I don't know, but we talked about nutrition. He recommended, you know, I'm doing 250 grams of protein. He recommended upping it to 300 grams of protein and lowering my fat a little bit, which 300 seems like a lot. I'm curious to hear what you guys think. But he recommended some of that. What else? There was something else I wanted to talk about. And the volume. We talked about the volume. Anyway. And then we did the pec deck, which was sick. And then we ended with some high to low cable flies, which I've not done in the past 6 months. I've not done those in, you know, 6 years, which felt awesome too. It was a good day, man. It was an almost, like, I'm trying to be modest. I won't say A+, but it was definitely an A, a strong A. Yeah, we're, I don't know, man. Just talking to him and listening to his, like, his experience with, like, competition and his diet. Oh, that's what I was going to talk about. He actually recommends that I don't cut at all. Because I showed him pictures of what it looked like before. He's like, dude, your body fat has went down so much. He's like, why are you trying to cut? He's like, you should be bulking. He's like, you should eat 4,000 calories instead of 3,100. He's like, I bet you wouldn't even gain that much weight if you upped your calories. And that got me thinking, too. Maybe I should postpone the cut. I don't know. I'm going to have to really, really think about this. And I'm curious to hear what you guys say, too. But maybe we just keep eating. Maybe we just keep eating a lot and keep getting these gains, you know? Because my body fat is going down. I know 25 was kind of steep. I would argue that I carry it well, for sure. I mean, my gut carries a lot of it. But, I mean, I can see my abs, for sure. But when we do cut, you know, I'm just doing the quick math off my head. If I do 15% body fat, if I could try to cut that much, I don't want to put a goal or a number in mind, because my body's going to change by the time I cut that much. But, you know, as of now, like, 205 would be really lean, 10%. But I don't think I'm going to be competition ready until I'm, like, a lean 220. So why not keep putting on a lot of muscle, slowly losing the fat, you know, main gain, if you will, maybe in a slight surplus, get to, like, 250 pounds at 25% body fat. And then we cut that. I don't know, man. It's just all stuff I gotta think about. And it's all stuff, you know. It's just this journey, dude. It's just fun. And I appreciate you guys hanging out and witnessing it with me. We're absolutely gonna compete one day. Absolutely gonna compete. It's gonna take time, but we're gonna be huge, and we're gonna be huge together. Just gains on gains, man. I watched some old school Hodge Twins last night. I'm just trying to find a little inspiration here and there to make this thing a little different. I'm not saying I want to be like the Hodge Twins, but I don't want any of y'all to think I'm just blatantly copying someone either. I love this raw format, and I'm just figuring this thing out as I go, you know. But anyway, happy 2024. I have a feeling that this is going to be everyone, all of our best year yet. It's going to be mine, man. It's going to be mine. I'm making a promise, dude. End of 2024. You guys ain't gonna be able to recognize me. All right, anyway, enough motivational chit-chat. I'm getting ready to pull into the house, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. We got legs tomorrow, another crazy day. Some squats. We're gonna lower the weight and do a lot more volume on squats. Try to work on that form a little bit. Anyway, all love. I'll catch you guys later.